us a blank one because we want this to be an animated logo. We're first going to change the canvas and use a gradient color like this gorgeous bluish gradient color. Next, we're going to add a rectangle. So you can press R for rectangle. The first step that you're going to start with is to creating an icon with this one. So create a rectangle icon. And you can use any colors that you like. So I'm going to use a grayish color for this one. And next step, I'm going to go back to my elements and go to shapes and lines and search for a triangle shape that is going to represent the front of our camera. Same color that I'm going to be using here. Next, you're going to rotate this and then align it to your design and set it to back. And then add another rectangle and change the color of this rectangle to the same color as your background. Because you're creating a gap. Like that, then you're going to go back to your elements and you're going to look for a circle. Once we start aligning our design, we're going to use a circle that animates. So for now, we're just going to use the circle. And your icon is done. So you can group the shapes so that you have a nice little icon and you add it on the side. Next, you're going to add text. You're going to press T for text. And you're going to type AR, which are the initials for all rounder media. So you're going to type AR and we are going to be using the font called Cooper BT. And we're going to increase this and make it a little bit bigger and change the font to Cooper BT. Now we're going to add an extra page and we're going to go back to our elements and we're going to look for a podium. Blue halo angel ring isolated on transparent background, abstract lines of movement. This is done by this creator that I don't know how to pronounce the name. Then you're going to add it to your design and you are going to use this podium as your part of your animation. In your podium, you're going to select it and you're going to click on animate to add animation to our logo. You're going to scroll down to the bottom of the page and find motion effects. Select rotate because we want this podium to rotate and stand up straight. So we're going to adjust the speed until we are happy with the speed that it's rotating. We don't want it to rotate all the way. We want it to rotate and stand straight. Okay, so we're going to have a look and see how it looks like. Maybe we can reduce the page a little bit so that it's 6 seconds and when it rotates until it's standing straight that way. Next, we're going to select our podium again and go to create an animation and then we're going to drag the element around. So we're going to move it now to the other side of the page. That's what we want. So we want the podium to rotate. And when it gets to the end of the page, it stands straight. Now we're ready to move our first page that we've created and drag it so that it's the second page. I don't like the colors, so we'll just adjust the colors. Next, we're going to add an extra page. And with our extra page, we're going to grab our podium, add it to the extra page, remove all animations on this podium, even the rotate, and then rotate it so that it is at the end. And then we're gonna add a transition. We're gonna use the dissolve animation. So with the dissolve animation, we're gonna just adjust it so that it sorts off, dissolves into the design like that. Add the dissolve transition and then adjust it so that it's 0.2 seconds and then it dissolves to the next page. Cool stuff. Then go to your elements and search for these little balls that are blobbing. They are called blob liquid effect gradient 0.7, created by Canva stickers. So you're gonna add the blob, rotate it on your second page, then select crop out the bigger side of the blob so that you only have the balls that are just blobbing from the ball, and then add them to the ball and send them back. Awesomeness. Have them blob nicely like that. Then reduce your second slide. Great stuff. Let's go copy the blob and the podium, add it to our logo and move it closer to our design. Oh, like I promised, I really would love to have these circles be circling as well, so I can go back to my elements and look for circle. Add sound. I get my free sounds from freesound.org and I download them from there, and I'm able to use them after I've uploaded. So we're just gonna add this movie sound on here and adjust it, and then add the shooting star sound as well, as and adjust it as well. If I want this to be longer, I would make it longer, but I have these shooting stars that I want to add on when the logo comes up. If you want to learn how to do a text reveal with your podium or shooting star, go find this video. We'll link it in the description. I will see you on our next video.